السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. ربنا زدنا علما، اللهم فقهنا في الدين، اللهم آمين. My dear children, how are you all doing today? We hope that you all are in the best state of iman and health. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep you all protected from all the bad things and from all the tests and trials of this world. Allahumma ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease all your work, and may Allah make it easy for you all to understand the Quran and to follow it. Allahumma ameen. Dear children, we have completed our ayahs from 17 until 20, alhamdulillah. In these ayahs, we learned about the two groups of hypocrites with examples. We also learned about their bad characteristics. But why did we study these bad characteristics? Yes, the main purpose of learning was to check ourselves and to see if we have any of these characteristics. The end of these hypocrites was bad, and in case if we are like them, na'udhu billah, we may also end up going to the lowest level of Jahannam like these hypocrites. So dear children, let us do a short recap of the lessons we learned from these ayahs, that is from ayah 17 until ayah 20. The first thing we learned was that whatever we do, our sole intention should be only to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we do anything to please the people around us, then we will get no reward for it. Yes, if we do anything sincerely only to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we will not only get the reward for it, but also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be pleased with us. Our lives will be blessed, and Allah will put love in other people's heart for us, and everyone will be happy with us. So what do we have to do? Yes, we have to think before we do anything. If this action of mine is only to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or my intention is something else, and if it is something which pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah will be pleased with you, and the people will also benefit. For example, a simple deed like removing a trash or a broken glass or a thorn from the path so that Allah is pleased with you. What will happen? Yes, definitely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be accepting this deed of yours. Why? Because your intention was pure, and also the people will benefit from it. Children, we have to keep our beliefs and faith strong. This means that we have to do everything with the intention of pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to gain guidance from Allah. To attain guidance, we have to have knowledge of Quran and the Hadith, and we have to learn the translation of the Quran by heart. How will this benefit us? This will benefit us when we are reciting the Quran or listening to the Quran. We will understand each and every word of it. When we will understand what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in the Quran, then only we will be able to practice according to its teachings. Allah has sent the Quran to us so that we live our lives according to it, not to read the Quran without understanding. And Allah did not send this Quran to us so that we read it for the people who are dead. But yes, the prayers and the supplications, the dua, is accepted after reading the Quran. We can pray for ourselves and for our loved ones who have left this world. It is Allah's will if He accepts our prayers, but the reward of our reading the Quran cannot be forwarded to someone else. This Quran is set down for the living people so that they read it, they understand it, and change their actions according to its teachings. Therefore, we have to use our eyes, our ears, and heart in a good way, as these are the means and the ways from where we can attain guidance. For this reason, we have to read the Quran with understanding, so that we know what our Lord is telling us to do. Then, when we understand what Allah is telling us, we have to do everything according to it. We should always have the intention, wish, and will to correct our actions according to the teachings of the Quran. My dear children, guidance is something which will be granted to us only if we wish for it, only if we search for it. Allah will open the path of guidance for us. If we love Allah, then we should love the Book of Allah as well. So how do we know that we love something? Yes, our love for something is defined by the amount of interest we show in it. Do we open the Quran every day? If we don't, then we need to work on ourselves. We need to spend more time with this book, with lots of interest. If we love our Lord, then we should also read the book of our Lord with love and care and enthusiasm and interest. If we have a strong connection with the book of Allah, the Quran, then definitely our hearts will be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today, inshallah, we will learn ayah number 21 of Surah Al-Baqarah. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. يا أيها الناس اعبدوا ربكم الذي خلقكم والذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. يا أيها الناس, O mankind, اعبدوا, worship, ربكم, your Lord, الَّذِي, the one who, خَلَقَكُمْ, created you, وَالَّذِينَ, and those who, مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ, before you, لَعَلَّكُمْ, so that you may, تَتَّقُونَ, become righteous or be saved. Translation: O mankind, worship your Lord, the one who created you, and those who came before you, so that you may become righteous. In this ayah, all of the mankind is being addressed. Ya ayyuhan nasu ubudu rabbakum. O people, worship your Lord. In this ayah, it is being told about the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to worship Allah alone. Children, do you remember in Surah Al-Fatiha we learned إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. Translation: You alone we worship and you alone we ask for help. In Surah Az-Zariyat, ayah number 56, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. And not I have created the jinn and the mankind except that they worship me. So dear children, in this ayah, we are being told about the purpose of our lives. Children, always remember that the purpose of our life is to believe in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obey all the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to only worship one Allah. For this, we have to have iman in our hearts, which means We have to have a strong belief that there is only one Lord and He has created us for a reason, which is to worship Him. And one can worship with all his heart only when he believes, when he loves, and then obeys all the commands and knows that he will get Jannah in reward of his obedience. In Jannah, we will get the blessings which no eyes have seen, no ears have ever heard, and no one can even think of it. Why should we worship? The answer to this question is being given in the second part of this ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. Allah is the one who has created you and who created your great-grandparents who came before you in this world, and now they are no more. Yes, children. So Allah has created us, and Allah is our creator, our khaliq, our master, our malik. We have to return to Him, and Allah is our provider, ar-raziq. And He is the one who fulfills all our needs, and Allah is the master of the day of judgment, malik yawm al-deen, meaning Allah will decide on the day of judgment whether a person will enjoy in the paradise or burn in the hellfire. In the last part of this ayah, it is being said that if we worship one Allah and obey Him, then what will be the benefit of it? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so that you are saved. Saved from what? From the fire of the hell. This also means that you become muttaqi, meaning you will have taqwa. Taqwa means the love of Allah and the fear of Allah. So you should worship Allah so that the love of Allah grows in your heart and the fear of Allah develops in your heart and you become the righteous one. So when do you think the love of Allah grows in our hearts? Yes, it is when we recognize Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and appreciate and thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we realize the greatness of Allah, the glory of Allah, then we fear that we should not do any such thing which Allah dislikes. My dear children, don't we all love our mothers? Yes, we love them a lot. But don't we fear them? Yes, we do fear them. We don't want to do anything that displeases them or upset our mothers, right? Similarly, a person, for the love of Allah, he will not do anything wrong. He will not do anything that would displease Allah. This is why Allah says, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to save us from the hellfire. That's why we are being asked to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to save ourselves from Allah's anger and to race in doing good deeds. So children, if we believe in one Allah and obey all the commands of Allah, be truthful, we will not backbite, we will not be jealous of anyone, we will not be anyone's enemy. Say our salahs, fast during the month of Ramadan and do good deeds, then we will be saved from the hellfire. When we act upon the teachings of the Quran, then inshallah our hearts will be cleaned. The clean heart means that all the bad things will go away from the heart and the good things will be present in our hearts. We will become the righteous ones. All the bad characteristics and traits such as lying, breaking promises, backbiting, jealousy, grudge, hate, and animosity will be taken away, will be taken out of our hearts. And our hearts will be filled with love, gratitude and thankfulness for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah has given us the biggest blessing of guidance, the blessing of reading and following the Quran and the Sunnah. Alhamdulillah. So we should have the love of Allah in our hearts more than anything else. We should be thankful and grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the blessings He has bestowed on us. We should also be thankful to our parents and everyone in our lives who become a part of giving us the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We pray that Allah opens up all the path of guidance for us and chooses us for His worship and obedience. Allahumma ameen. Children, take care of yourselves and your family. See you all in the next class, inshallah. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.